ladies and gentlemen, and as always, thank you for watching. Today we've got a customer who's called us. We have a truck and a loaded trailer that is broken down in the middle of some road construction up here. Just a basic tow, but that is one of the most dangerous things we can do. Just a basic pickup on the side of the interstate is extremely, extremely dangerous. Thus the reason, you know, we're constantly trying to support the slow down, move over. People don't realize how dangerous it truly is out there. Anyway, we're gonna go help this driver out. He's in a bad spot apparently. He was able to get partially off the side of the road, but it's still in the middle of the road construction. So anyway, here we go.
Back onto the interstate.
prove challenging. Thankfully, he found a wide spot that'll give us a little bit more room.
My friend,
good. How you doing?
All right, my name's Ron.
I'm Phil.
Phil,
you need these?
I
only got one. I can't find the other.
I've got some if I have to lift it up.
All right,
let me get some cones out behind you and get my light bar on you. Try to get some people scooted over.
Right.
I know it's going to be tough because of just the way this is designed.
I know
they got we bought. I had the other one that had red and blues in it. I put that one in the Western Star. This one's actually got a traffic advisor and strobes and work lights and all kind of stuff built into it. We'll get it set up here first. They'll pay attention, but it's got a traffic advisor on it, so so set that up here first, then I'll go get some cones. At least they'll have to hit them before they hit us. Cones on the other side. If it's the rear end, we have to tow this a different way.
You have to tow it backwards, don't you?
Either have to tow it backwards or have to knock the axle shafts out. And you got those caps all over it.
Yeah, see there?
Oh, no. That would be the rear end out.
That's what I just thought. Yep.
Shoot. Well. Yep.
So we're gonna have to drop the trailer.
No. The only way to do it is pop the axle shafts out.
Okay.
Which means we got to pull these out.
Okay.
Yep. I'll finish putting the cones up. If you want to get, I'd appreciate it if you don't mind helping get those caps off. Yeah, just watch that driver's side. ahead, sir. Go ahead.
All right.
Good glasses. Shafts. You have to do front and rear. Gum cones on them. Or is it? No, thankfully no. No, it is not. Thank you. Watch out for this traffic, my friend.
Oh yeah, I am.
I'm gonna go ahead and get both of these ready to pop. That one's already starting to leak a little bit, which is good. Transmission was out, but it's a rear end and I'm having to pull the axle shafts, and it's got oil scattered all over, and it's right here in the middle of this construction southbound at the 99. He's right where the Jackson traffic comes on and hits the southbound. He'll have to go all the way to the 103 and come back. Yeah, get the traffic control and a couple of bags of oil dry, please. Thank you. you on the phone?
Not now.
Oh, okay. I've got our traffic control truck coming up. I wasn't planning on having to pull the axle shafts. He's going to bring some oil dry so we can clear that up.
Oh, okay.
Also, that'll help. He can carry the axle shafts. We can mark them, and he can carry the axle shafts.
All right,
yeah.
I'll finish. Up to Benton, right?
Today, we're supposed to take you down to our place and drop the trailer, and they're going to send somebody after the trailer, and then tomorrow, we're supposed to take the truck up to Benton.
Oh, gotcha. All
yeah, right. yeah. Normally, we would have, our road tractor is in use right now, pulling our Trailey's trailer. Otherwise, we could have split this and used our road tractor.
Yep.
Could have used a road tractor to haul your trailer, nudge this enough forward, you know, to where we could have grabbed the back end of it.
Right. Now, is there a truck stop somewhere on our way to your shop?
Yeah, just down the street from us.
Because I got to get some reefer fuel in here, just in case they don't come pick it up until later.
We'll pull in there on our way down.
Because I was supposed to get fuel down the road here at a Love's.
Okay.
And it broke down here, so I can't.
Yeah, we'll take care of it.
Right.
We passed right by it on the way to our shop. So
sweet.
We'll get your reefer tank fueled up. Oh, no problem. That's what we're here for. We're here to help. I'm gonna go ahead and finish getting hooked up and everything tied up while I'm waiting on him.
Yeah. Hello.
Do you have any?
Oh,
go ahead. It's exit 91. It's the border, southern border of Cape Girardeau, northern border of Scott City.
Okay, it's right on the border of Scott City and Cape Girardeau.
Exit 91. Yep. Those are locked in. That'll work for my breakaways. Do what, sir? Oh, sorry. time, it would feel nice. Welcome to sit in the truck if you'd rather.
I'm fine. A little breeze out now.
Thank you.
That's where I knocked the nuts loose on it. That's why I've had him bring some oil dry up. And watch your back. Don't ever trust that traffic. Just stay on this side if you would.
Yeah.
It's
that driver, he's gonna stay hooked up until we get there. That way you can tell him where to park.
Gotcha. Have to give plenty of room for this to pivot. Give it some extra. Thank you. two washers on that other side I still gotta get. Oh.
Rear axle.
Back in here. Thank you. I'm ready to go except for picking up the cones and pulling the axle shafts. The nuts and everything are out, they're popped loose. I just need to pull them out and put them in the bed of this truck.
Okay.
We're good to go now. I finished everything else up while you were circling. We just need to make sure we remember which one goes where.
Okay.
Cause I don't have them marked. I don't have a paint pen with me.
Yeah, I didn't either. Okay.
Yeah.
We can do them the way they're laid out.
Yeah.
Like, that's the left rear. How you got that one in there?
Yeah.
If you roll it back just a little bit, we can do left rear. And there's the left front. If I can get it down in there. There we go. Then we'll do the same thing on the other side. Yeah, somebody lost it.
I need that one.
This would have been so much quicker if our semi was available. But it's out working, so I'm not going to complain.
Pretty warm.
Yeah, they're warm. Yeah, they're warm. I needed them to get off my butt. That's why I had all these cones and everything else out. It's right here in a bad spot where it joins. So let's not talk about it. Let's get out of here.
It sounds like a play.
Oh, and I need your guys' address so I can send it to my dispatcher. Send it to me so I can have the other driver pick up that trailer in the morning,
right there.
First thing in the morning.
There you go.
I said, all right, I will.
It should have everything you need on her.
All right, cool. Get the website here.
All right. I'm taking off. Are you good?
I'm good.
Fasten your seatbelt, please.
Yes, that's what I'm doing.
Because I have to wait until I can find a clearer opening. As you saw, traffic does not slow down.
No, no, it don't. No, it don't.
All right, we've got somewhat of a hole, so here we go.
Here we go.
Tom's running traffic for us back there, so.
All right, good deal. All right, now, flap gate.
get a motel, or can I stay in your yard tonight with the truck?
You can stay in the truck. That's
okay.
Fine. That's,
all right. You guys drove all night then?
No, but part of our lot will be, you're welcome to stay in the truck.
All right, because I was like, there ain't no sense me getting a motel tonight because I'll have to get one tomorrow anyway. You know, I'll be good to tomorrow.
No, you're more than welcome to stay.
I got supper in the truck already.
There you go. And if you don't have anything, we can run you down the truck stop.
Oh, no, I'm fine. I got everything I need. I really do. Okay.
Darn it.
I gotta wait till we get up to the truck up to your
I was saying darn it, because I got these new expensive glasses that were supposed to help with my eyes and the sun, because I got a problem with the sunlight.
Yeah.
And scratched lenses on today, got things.
Oh.
South then.
Okay.
I guess.
Yeah.
Bloomsdale is, what is it? Probably 80 miles north.
80 miles? Oh, okay.
Something like that. Yeah, it's not too bad.
Yeah, yeah. All right.
All right. You'll drop the trailer.
Yeah, you might have to lock the brakes and back up a little bit, take the pressure off there.
Yeah, let me pull the pin. I'll just have to do that here.
I have to do it with the truck sometimes, you know?
Yep.
Just as long as he can get this one, he can come over on the other side right along those that line of wrecked cars.
Wrecked
yep.
All right.
And then park me off to the side somewhere. Here, I'll get that.
Sure?
Yeah.
I don't mind. It's part of my job.
I'll get her.
I'll finish getting this undone then. Before I forget it.
Oh yeah,
don't
forget that.
No.
It'll be all free, yeah. Appreciate it, there you go.
Come on. Well, thank you.
You bet.
Come on, baby, come on.
That grease feels good, don't it?
Yes, it does.
Yes, just park me over somewhere out in the corner somewhere.
Well, I'll have to put it to where, whenever we grab it in the morning, we can grab the back end.
Oh, all right, yeah.
Make it. Yeah. Oh, yeah. We'll put you on that new part of the lot that I was telling you about a while ago. My truck, however, I know you wouldn't think so, but that truck that you were just riding in weighs a little over 72,000, and it will sink out there.
This truck, the wrecker truck.
Yeah.
Yeah. I can believe that. Yeah.
People ask all the time, what is the baking soda for? The baking soda neutralizes acids, such as battery acid. Primary use in our industry. Thank you. goes to if you'll wait just a minute, I'll have everything lowered down. That way we can, I'll disconnect it and we'll drop everything down. That way it's all ground level. All right, I'll leave this hooked up. Do you have a dump switch in here?
I do.
That's all right. You just tell me where it's at. Right there. Should have been it. Oh, no. Didn't work. I don't think. Or did it?
You see the switch with the arrow going down?
Yeah.
That's it.
It's not lighting up or anything. Oh, well, that's all right. We'll make it. Hi, buddy. What you doing?
We're out for a stroll.
You want to help watch? You going to help watch? Had my little buddy, huh? Had my little buddy.
Yeah,
it is kind of bright. I'm getting ready. You want to watch this while I pull out? I couldn't get his air to dump.
You want me?
Yeah. If you don't mind, just watch that while I pull out, because I'm kind of at an angle. Oh. Dad and my grandson, Wesson.
Hi buddy. Thank you.
as well put the axle shafts on the deck.
Put them up there
and then we'll strap them down. Might help if I level it out, huh? Hold on just a second. Then whoever tows it tomorrow can tie them up better if they want.
What time will you be ready tomorrow?
About,
I'll be ready.
Round of eight.
Round eight? Okay.
Yep. Yeah, we're gonna have to get another one anyway. It needs to be a lot more secure than that. All right, I'm gonna go drop it out. Thanks, Tom. Papa and Wesson are driving. Hello? Yo. Yeah, bud. Okay. Ah, darn it. Okay. Okay. Okay, you said Park Street East and Chestnut. Okay. All right. Yeah, I'm dropping just finished pulling a truck and trailer in. I'm just finished dropping them out, and we'll head that way. All right. Thank you. Bye. Thank you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, there she is. We'll finish hooking her up tomorrow and get it on up to St. Louis to the Kenworth dealership. We're back safely at the shop as always. Thank you for watching and God bless.